You talk about a rising star in coaching. What he's done with that program, just got beat though by Missouri.
Yeah.
And Steiner, after beating Oklahoma State, maybe Washington.
Well, you better value the basketball in this game today.
And a new Georgia Tech.
Yeah, of course they did. Beat them by double figures.
Adam Morrison was sensational.
And the three goes down for Jarrett Jack on the feed from Will Bynum.
And that's where he really improved his game. Maturity, shot selection. Early in this game, Kansas is taking a lot of bad shots.
Well, Kahn needs somebody to give the basketball to. Finally, Langford helps him out. And Langford is fouled by Anthony Morrow.
Langford's a driving player. Likes the moment, likes the score. And the spotlight's on, he usually responds.
Well, the spotlight, Dick, is on here today. And Georgia Tech has responded, up 16 here in Kansas. Basketball team, Dick, you got to have an elite point guard, and each of these teams can make that play.
Well, you know, I think the theme right now in college basketball, there's so many great ones. I mean, I don't see the name Travis Diener on here. I don't see the name of
Carl Krauser, yeah,
who's terrific at Pittsburgh. But you only can put so many names. Those are my super six right now. I love Williams down in Illinois. He runs more like a second guard. Felton is sensational. Certainly Paul and Jack are just terrific players. And they really cause the efficiency that their teams have offensively.
McHenry with a block on Moody. Bynum exploding to the other end. It bounces off his leg out of bounds back to Kansas.
Defensive transition is a must against Georgia Tech. The way they kick the ball out. Watch the block shot by McKendry. There's the block.
Now Bynum is called for a foul.
They made a statement last year, was their statement game. That was beating Connecticut.
Early.
In New York early. They sent a loud message that we're legit. Then they followed it up with other big wins. A win at Duke. And you could see they were ready to play anybody, anytime. And they really have done an amazing job.
To do what they did to get to the national championship game with their leading scorer, really, hobbled by an ankle injury, hardly played in three of the tournament games, didn't score in two of them. They lost 10 games during the season, but they learned from that adversity. They dealt with it, and they were better off because of it.
And that's when you're a real team, when everybody else steps up, and you got everybody participating, contributing.
Rashawn Dickey, a freshman out of Plyo, South Carolina. Big guy, 6'9".
He can post inside. Yeah. He's an excellent post player. Both these teams are going to lose a lot of quality players next year, but they will not rebuild. They will reload.
Their coaches have seen to that. Both of them are outstanding recruiters. Block underneath by Kahn. Robinson hits Langford.
Nice
hits Kahn.
Great transition right there. Kahn does a great job running the break. Langford with the good look, the good vision. Ball never really touched the floor. Excellent job in transition.
Now Muhammad turns it over.
They need a spurt. They go in that locker room feeling good about themselves. They have to go on a spurt.
How about Kahn with the block shot, Dick, and then the big guy runs the floor and gets rewarded at the other end.
He does right there. Look at the movement of the basketball. Trail man. Great execution. Fill the lane.
Kahn playing sparingly, but getting a chance. Simeon's out with an injury. Giles picked up three early fouls. So now Sasha Kahn trying to show Bill Self he deserves some playing time.
Russell Robinson's going to be a star here at Kansas.
That's him with the ball right now. Number three, 12 points in their win over Wisconsin-Milwaukee, and some big buckets late in a four-point win over South Carolina.
South Carolina lost the heartbreaker as well to Pittsburgh.
Langford misses the three. Skying for the rebound is Jack. We'll have an update after half on B.J. Elder's situation, left with what we've been told is a strained hamstring.
Langford and certainly J.R. Giddens are going to really have to elevate their game.
Venture pretty quiet so far today at the offensive end, but he's got a lot of help. A lot of different guys can score for Georgia Tech, including this guy. It rims out on Jack. Rebound Giddens.
Venture, an excellent passer from the post. They're not utilizing him enough inside.
Robinson from the wing, not there. Kansas now 1-for-7 from three-point range.
Because they're not good shots. That's poor shot selection.
Look at the spin by Muhammad. Doesn't finish. Georgia Tech getting to the loose balls.
Shot selection is so important in becoming a winning basketball team. Understanding what a good shot is. So many teams hurry up. They don't have patience.
McHenry gets Giddens in the air, goes around him. And a strong rebound underneath by Kahn.
Kahn really going to earn some playing time.
Giddens. The baseline jumper is there.
Where has he been? He's got so much ability. Came on strong last year. Made that big three to send the game in overtime against Georgia Tech.
And Schenter is fouled from behind before the shot by Sasha Khan. Hey, January 6th marks the debut of ESPN 2 HD, and we've got a winner. We're not going to tell you just now, but DePaul, Cincinnati, Memphis, Texas, Gonzaga, Santa Clara, you, the folks at home, voted and determined where you're going to send Dickie V packing. The game that you're going to, Dick, it's all going to become clear to us after halftime.
Where am I going?
Open up
where
your
am I
suitcase.
Going?
Nice suitcase.
Where am I going? Where am I going?
I can't tell you.
Come on, tell me where I'm going.
The debut of ESPN 2 HD. To get ESPN 2 HD, call your local cable operator or satellite provider. It's either DePaul, Cincinnati, Gonzaga, Santa Clara, or Memphis, Texas.
Schenker shooting 59% from the field. You got to see that he's got to get more touches inside. He's got very few touches thus far because the game has been at such a fast pace.
That happened a little bit in the Gonzaga game as well, where Paul Hewitt had to take him out of the game for extended periods because the teams were going small and quick, and there wasn't that much of a role for him.
People probably wonder what makes a Paul Hewitt or Bill Self so successful. It's their great communication ability. You can have all the talent in the world. If you can't communicate your concepts and the things you believe in and get the players to trust you, to believe in you, it's very difficult. And both guys do an amazing job in that area.
Schenker knocking down his free throws, and the Georgia Tech lead is back to 14. Giddens got in the air, was thinking about the three. Langford came over and took the pass. Now on the floor for Kansas, number 32, Darnell Jackson, a freshman out of Oklahoma City. Giddens for three. That's the second quick three and bad three that he's taken here today.
He has become a three-point shooter almost exclusively, and that's why it's limited his effectiveness in going to the free throw line. Five attempts all year.
And again, with Simeon out, everybody has to take their play up a notch. Giddens, no exception. Inside, Dickey the miss, follows his rebound. Moody keeps it in bounds to Miles. Miles all the way. This is with the left hand. Now Georgia Tech's got a 3-on-0. Muhammad.
Wow. Big time athlete. High riser. Nobody rotated back. Miles took the ball to the goal. Your offside guard has got to rotate back to protect the goal when the point guard penetrates. You know who misses Simeon the most, other than Bill Self, obviously, is Miles.
Miles, yeah.
Miles really misses him.
Ismail Mohammed, a regular on SportsCenter's Top 10 Plays, showing you why here today. ...31-15, Georgia Tech leading Kansas after that spectacular dunk on the 3-on-0 runout for Georgia Tech. Kansas, Dick, when they played South Carolina here recently, was down 11-0 to begin the game, and it took them the entire game to get back into it. That was the game, actually, where Simeon hurt his thumb. He left, then came back and played the second half. But he's not playing here today. What does Kansas have to do to get back into this game?
Well, we talked about it. They have to find a way to get Giddens and certainly Langford to start giving them some point production, because without Simeon on the inside, very difficult to get anything in the three-point area,
I liked how he said to Doris Burke, she said to him, you know, Coach Self is saying you might be back in 4 weeks, and he got a big smile on his face, and he said, I'm hoping for quicker than 4 weeks.
Well, you don't want to be impatient if you're, you know, a youngster, because obviously more is at stake come February and March.
Miles sets his feet and knocks down the three. There's a good-looking three-point shot.
That's the second good-looking one he's had.
Yep. Miles doesn't take many, but this year he's hitting them at a better than 50% clip. Now he's got a rebound.
Very economical in the ones that he takes.
Miles, whoa, swatted away. I think that was McHenry.
See, Miles right now is saying, I have to help this ball put some points on the board, and he's asserting himself. That's leadership.
Yep.
That's what we define as a leader. Somebody that understands what's happening on the floor, and Miles is a great winner. Look at that block. Look at that rise. Wow.
McHenry with the elevation and the dunk. Georgia Tech up double figures on the road.
And Doris, back to you guys.
That's the best Diggers look. That's the best he's looked. I'll tell you what. That's the best he's looked.
Happy New Year, Digger. Happy New Year, David. Glad to see you guys. Georgia Tech up on Kansas by 13. This is a game, again, let's go back to the NCAA tournament last year when Georgia Tech eliminated Kansas in the Elite Eight. As you can see, that Georgia Tech has capitalized much better on the turnovers than Kansas has. And this is a big game for Paul Hewitt's team, no question about it. But for the folks here in Kansas, they've been talking about this game for months.
Well, I'll tell you, it's been an impressive first half thus far for Georgia Tech. I don't care the fact that Simeon's gone on the floor. They have come out with a mindset defensively. They've really done what they've had to do. They're attacking the basket in transition.
Giddens fortunate to avoid an injury as Muhammad went flying, and I mean flying at him, to try and contest that three.
And he left something on the floor. What did he leave on the floor? What did he leave on the floor? He left something on the floor.
Little lingerie.
Wow. That little pump fake, he went flying in the sky. They got some outstanding recruits coming in next year. We talk Georgia Tech, certainly Kansas as well.
Kansas had a big situation with Micah Downs out of Seattle, where he and his father talked to a Seattle newspaper apparently saying they're definitely going to the NBA. That's at least how it looked in the paper. As Giddens knocks down a three, but then they kind of retracted the comments and said it still could go either way.
Look at the defensive play by Miles to create the turnover. Giddens knocks it down, makes the three. And see, making that three sometimes with J.R. Giddens, as you watch him right here. He spots up. He's got great range. He loves that three. And I think he negates attacking the basket. He's such a great athlete.
Miles off to Jackson, the 17-footer. No. And a foul underneath on Georgia Tech. At this point on the stats monitor that we have, Miles has not been credited with any assists here today. He clearly should get one for that bucket.
Exactly.
By Giddens, so that's at least one. Remember, he needs four today to tie Jock Vaughn's all-time KU record of 804 career assists.
Jock Vaughn was one of my favorite players. What a great team he played on. They were terrific. Had two tough losses. Lost to Arizona in the Sweet 16. And Arizona went on in 97 to win the national title. All those kids that were on that Roy Williams team graduated. They were class, a super team.
Giddens again, a little bit short. Muhammad, the kick ahead to Jack. All the way for Jack, and he is fouled. Boy, how do you slow him down as strong as he is when he gets in transition?
See, that's an example why Schencher doesn't get a lot of touches, because they beat people in transition.
Yep.
And you don't want to stop running, because they run, baby, they run.
The foul on Michael Lee, his first. Jack at the line for a pair.
Well, he's coming back next year, and then they bring in Lewis Clinch. He comes in, a 6'3 guy, and a guy by the name of Austin Jackson from out of the Dallas area. DeAndre Bell, Alade Aminu. They have four good prospects. Jackson, they tell me, you'd be interested in being a baseball expert. They say it could be a first-round draft choice in baseball.
Boy, what a tough choice, college basketball or pro baseball.
Do them both. You could do both.
Yeah, Jack knocks him down. Langford into the game, and now for Kansas, replacing Michael Lee, a talented freshman on Georgia Tech. Sam Frederick II, out of St. Matthews, South Carolina, number 35, has come in. The state of South Carolina's all-time leading high school scorer, and his dad could fill it up, right?
His dad was a big-time scorer in high school. Suddenly one of the all-time leading scorers in the state.
Miles with his Curly Neal impression. Keeps his dribble alive for a moment, now finds Giddens.
I like that Curly Neal, Shows me he got some basketball tradition in here. Harlem Globetrotter superstar.
Shot clock at 5. Miles the floater. Somebody got a finger on that. Moody underneath.
Nice play by Moody with the offensive rebound. They're getting a little run here. I'd like to get it into single digits. That would be a plus for them.
It was up around 16, 17 for a while, but they've got it down to 10 right now.
Not only was it up, they were being embarrassed on their home floor, having a tough time to score early in the game.
Jack trying to post, finds the cutter, Theotis Tarver. Giddens ties them up. Tarver retains possession. Now it is thrown away, but there was a whistle before on a travel. You can't hear the whistle. You can't hear anything here today.
Carver's had a history of problems physically, had a knee problem.
A junior out of Monroe, Louisiana, averaging about 11 minutes per game. He and McHenry set screens, defend, rebound, and lead the scoring to the scorers. And they got plenty of those in the yellow jerseys today, even with Elder out with a strained hamstring right now. Final minute of the first half. Kansas trying to make a run.
And double up on Langford to get the ball out of his hands.
Get it. When the feet are set, it goes down. The quick ones have it.
Well, he spread his body, had a great look. Good ball with those four. They're back. The Jayhawks are back. Run, chalk, Jayhawks. Run, chalk, Jayhawks.
Tarver tied up.
They're out of sync right now. Georgia Tech.
And that's going to get space.
And that's a ball jumping up on the sideline about. Got a chance for a score here. This place looks slow.
Langford. Rebound Tech. 10 seconds to go. And Moody fouls Schencher.
Silly foul. Great effort, but a silly foul. Got to know the score. Got to know the board. The boy Hewitt.
Meanwhile, Giddens starting to heat up. But Dick, he's taking some bad ones and he's taking some good ones. The ones where the feet are set, they go down for him.
Ewing was trying to get a timeout with that possession. And nobody could see him.
Nobody could hear him.
Yeah, nobody could hear him, see him.
In his pin.
Players have about Louis jumping up and down. He's like Baryshnikov. That's an invitation of years ago. Louis caught a second jumping on that sideline.
Right. Schencher at the line. You can see that Georgia Tech, since Elder went out of the game with that injury, that's when Kansas has made a bit of a comeback. Well, Schencher gets a lot of air underneath those free throws, but they go down for him, and there is the attention that Elder's getting. We've been told it's a strained left hamstring. He's got it wrapped as he's come back to the bench.
Well, the two stars, the two scoring stars on the sideline, Simeon on one side and Elder on the other. These teams are more than about an individual. You saw that as you documented earlier last year when they were without Elder and went for the final game for losing the Huskers
with time. Miles drives and he's fouled. Miles will go to the line. Look at his teammates hustle over to pick him up off the floor.
Well, I'll tell you one thing. He has really shown some great leadership skills here today. Roy Williams has told me on numerous occasions how he's a special kid with a winner's mentality. There he is attacking the basket. He realizes they have no post game, so now he's becoming a little bit more assertive offensively.
Second foul on Anthony McHenry. Miles will shoot a couple.
You know, I mentioned Roy Williams 2 years in a row to the Final Four. I get a feeling sometimes, and it bothers me, that some of the people really didn't appreciate the unbelievable job, not good job,
here.
Unbelievable job he did here. When you mix with some of their fans coming up to me saying, hey, we don't want to hear about Roy Williams. We want to hear about, well, I'm going to tell you, you're going to hear about Roy Williams because he did a phenomenal job here.
Back-to-back Final Fours, and then last year, Bill Self's first year, they go to the Elite Eight, losing to Georgia Tech. 2.3 seconds to play. This is the closest Kansas has been since the opening minutes of the game.
Last 5 minutes, he's got to be happy with their effort, especially defensively.
Will not count. Did not go, wouldn't have counted if it had. We're at half here at Allen Fieldhouse in Kansas, and the Jayhawks have gotten up off the mat. A 12-3 run to close the half, and they now trail Georgia Tech only by 7, 34-27 at halftime. Doris Burke is standing by with Tech coach Paul Hewitt.
Coach, how did Kansas hurt you during that late run?
Started turning the ball over a little bit and got a little tentative. I thought early in the game we did a nice job attacking the bucket. Late there, we fumbled it a couple times going to the basket.
If BJ's not available in the second half, how does that change what you do?
Well, obviously, we're missing a great scorer, but we're just going to have to, you know, make amends. We've got some guys got to step up. Anthony Morrow, Sam Frederick, those guys, they'll fill the void.
All right, Coach, good luck in the second half. Dan?
Thank you, Doris. That's something they did last year when Elder got hurt in the NCAA tournament with great success. Georgia Tech by 7 at the half. David Amber, Digger Phelps, the UPS Halftime Report.
All right, welcome to the UPS Halftime Report. David Amber and Digger Phelps. Happy New Year, everyone, and really a tale of two halves there, the one with B.J. Elder and really the one without B.J. Elder momentum right now on the Jayhawks side.
And the reason why, when you're up 16 and Georgia Tech had that lead, they sort of panicked. But Kansas did the right thing. Get it under 10. That's what you try to tell your kids. Just get it to 9. Obviously, they have it to 7. But now you got to look in that second half. Well, I just think when you look at what Kansas can do, better shot selection, keep control of the ball. Don't turn it over. But more importantly, when you look at what's going to happen to me, Jarrett Jack had 29 points that first game. He's got to take this game over for Georgia Tech to stay in this win.
Jayhawks just 4 points in the first 8 minutes, but they are very much in this ball game. Loads more coming up on the UPS Halftime Report. Digger tells us why the road to the Final Four may go through North Carolina and why you can't forget the Huskies' big little man. Huge predictions from Digger. That's next.
Welcome to the UPS Halftime Report.
Number two, Kansas, trying to go 9-0 for the first time since 96-97 when they started 22-0. They're down by 7, though, as we get set for second half action in just a few minutes. Welcome back to the UPS Halftime Report. David Amber and Digger Phelps, a new look for 2005. I like the look, and I think I know why you're wearing that, because we need some predictions for the next 3 months. Who's going to be making some madness in March?
Well, I got to look at the 205 crystal balls. I'm looking inside. I've got to pull it up, and see what I get. Oh, not Halloween. I need New Year's Day. Dick, get out of there. This is my show. Now I want to bring teams in that I think are going to be the teams to beat. And right now, we got to talk about the team to beat. They're not number five in the coaches' poll. They should be number one in the coaches' poll, and that's North Carolina. Why? They got balance inside and outside. That a guy named Juwan Williams, who is, to me, the silent enforcer to go with Felton, McCants, as well as May. And yet, when you look at the depth they have, it's led by Melvin Scott, the point guard that makes things happen with four guys coming off the bench. And this is why I pick Carolina as the team to win the national title as we go into 2005. Arizona. Well, they got this guy called Channing Frye. Is he their Okafor? He could be if they give him the ball. He had 18 and 16 against Mississippi State and Lawrence Roberts. But when you look at the balance of that team, Salam Stoudemire, this team could be one team that could show up in March Madness in St. Louis. Well, what's going on with Syracuse? Look at all these RPIs in the Cupcake City. All of them just lousy. Even the 5-point win over Hofstra. Is this going to catch up to Boeheim and company? Well, when they go to Notre Dame on the first big Monday, January 10th, it's not going to be McNamara. It's not going to be Wark. It's this other guy that I love, the pacemaker, Josh Pace, who to me, even though they lost to Oklahoma State, it was 45-45 in the Garden in the Jimmy V. And then all of a sudden, Oklahoma State goes on that 17-4 run to win the game big time. It's going to be the pacemaker, Josh Pace, making Syracuse a contender to go out after that Big East title. So these are the teams that I really like, but let's talk about a couple key players that are going to make impact on their ball clubs. So let's start with Kentucky. And Kentucky and Tubby Smith went where? To Western Kentucky to get Patrick Sparks, who's the transfer. And boy, was he a spark against Louisville when he started knocking down threes, making things happen, takes the pressure off Chucky Hayes inside. Tubby Smith's defense with Sparks on the outside on the offense makes Kentucky now a chance to get not just an SEC title, but a chance to be number one as a seed in the NCAA tournament. Now we've got to go out west. Yes, there's this little guy. Is he 5'9"? Some people think he's 5'7 and 3/4, but it's Nate Robinson, who even last night as they open up with a big 14-point win over Cal, he wasn't in double figures. Five other guys were. This is the team to beat in the Pac-10, not Arizona. They beat Arizona three times last year, and this is why I like this team to win the Pac-10 title. So there you have it, inside and outside.
All right. Thank you, Miss Cleo. I mean, Digger Phelps. Yeah. Huskies 11-1, a very strong start for them. That's not all from Digger. We're going to get your surprises from 2004. That's when the UPS Halftime Report rolls on, so keep it locked right here on ESPN. I like that.
This Halftime Report is delivered by UPS. What can Brown do for you? Welcome back to the UPS Halftime Report.
Happy New Year again, David Amber and Digger Phelps. Digger, we got your predictions. Now we need your surprises as far as 2004 wrapping up.
Well, we got to go right to the Big 12 and take a serious look now at Missouri. Even though they lost to Davidson at home earlier in the year, it doesn't mean anything. When they played, in my opinion, against Illinois in St. Louis, the second half made the difference. But when they knocked off Gonzaga, it was Jason Conley, the transfer from VMI, who led the scoring in nation scoring when he was a freshman. But his 16.13 rebounds, to me, was the reason why they just become a different team. Also, when you take a look at the bench, Melvin Watkins, the former coach of Texas A&M, is now an associate head coach on the bench with Quinn Snyder, just like George Blaney is with UConn and Jim Calhoun. That depth gives you not just experience, but coaching decisions that are right decisions. That's why I like Missouri now sneaking in the Big 12 to get an NCAA bid.
As well, there's some other surprise, I guess, in Iowa.
I love Iowa in the Big Ten. Steve Alford, who was on the hot seat during this year when they went over to Maui, the wins over Texas and Louisville got it done. And now the way they beat Texas Tech by 30, people know this 12-1 club, to me, is a challenge to beat a fourth team behind Wisconsin, Illinois, and Michigan State in the Big Ten.
Big Ten just three bids last year. Looking for some more bids. We're looking for some more big plays in our second half. Thanks for joining us on the UPS Halftime Report. Ishmael Muhammad, Dunkalicious, a 7-point lead, G-Tech. Second half action coming your way next.
This halftime report is delivered by UPS. What can Brown do for you? ESPN's exclusive presentation of college basketball is brought to you by Nissan. Everything we touch, we shift. And everything we shift, we try to make better.
Well, it's a holiday for most, but not for the guys playing here today. A great effort by Georgia Tech and then Kansas in the comeback at the end, getting a 16-point deficit down to 7. At times it wasn't pretty, but you can see that the talent and the effort is there for these teams to be elite teams.
Well, wait a minute now. You said it's not a holiday for the guys playing. What about the guys working? This is the first 2 years I've worked on it, 26 years.
This isn't work.
No, travel is work.
Yeah.
Hey, I can tell you this, though. If Kansas is going to win this basketball game, they got to get Mr. Langford going. He's 1-for-8. I will not get it done.
Well, I got news for you. You're traveling again because it's time to reveal the Send Dickey V Packing, where you're going on January the 6th. The folks at home voted on ESPN.com.
Wow.
And is it DePaul, Cincinnati? Is it Memphis, Texas? Or is it Gonzaga, Santa Clara?
Memphis, Texas.
There you go.
Austin's a great city.
Yeah, it is.
We're going to Austin, Texas. Let's hope that John Calipari's team could step up and make it a great night of basketball.
The debut of ESPN 2 HD, and it really wasn't even very close. As you can see, Memphis, Texas winning by 16% over Gonzaga, Santa Clara. So you and I got a date in Austin on January the 6th.
Austin, that's going to be phenomenal.
That's a beautiful town.
Then January 8th, I got a date with my guy Brad Nessler. I got North Carolina and Maryland, ACC.
Right.
It starts now, baby. It really starts. And we get paid for this. It's stealing money. Don't tell my boss.
Let's take a look at the game track from the first half. Jarrett Jagdic, just like in the NCAA tournament last year, just willing his team the way he played today, played with great toughness. B.J. Elder got hurt, but then the comeback at the end of the half by Kansas.
Well, the comeback was sparked by the two threes by Giddens. They have to find a way, as you look at the run, 12-3, to get them into a single-digit deficit. But Langford is too good a player. He's 1-for-8, and without Simeon playing, they have no shot to win here unless Langford has a good second half.
Langford, 2 points. Miles in the first half, 7 points and an assist. Jack, the high scorer, with 10 points. Also, McHenry, 5 points, 5 rebounds, and 3 blocks for the Yellow Jackets. Kansas with the first possession of the second half.
Well, I know he impressed Mark Bradley, the fine writer from the Atlanta Constitution. He told me earlier, he said, hey, McHenry, blocking shots, defending, he can guard anyone. He's right.
One change in the starting lineup for Kansas. Moulay Nyan instead of C.J. Giles. A quick foul on McHenry of Georgia Tech. And a quick update from Doris Burke.
For Bill Self, he wants better ball and better body movement. He'd like to see his guys get into the paint. He said we need to stop transition. And just an update, we will not see B.J. Elder in the second half, guys.
All right, Doris, thank you. And we will not see Anthony McHenry for a while. That foul was his third, so he has to go out if Theotis Tarver checks in for the Yellow Jackets.
Fortunately, they're a deep basketball team and going to rotate a lot of bodies off that bench. Georgia Tech certainly going to need them in life in the ACC. Hey, do you realize there's a school, D-U-K-E? They haven't lost yet, and nobody's talking about them except Paul Ewing. He told me, he said, if there's one player that has stepped up and is really having a phenomenal year and gets very little publicity, and he's right, is Daniel Ewing.
No question.
Ewing, as a combination guard, is one of the premier guards in America.
Dion has it blocked by Schencher. Well, Duke, one of only 8 remaining unbeaten. Kansas is among them as well. Don't forget, Princeton at Duke Wednesday night on ESPN.
Princeton, one of the leaders again. Defense in terms of points scored against.
Two men guarding Schencher inside. They're going to play off Tarver a little bit. Not really much of an offensive threat.
And doubling up on Schencher.
Bynum. was looking for the foul. The tip by Tarver is good.
And the reason Tarver had the opening for the tip, two people were on Schencher, and he had a clear lane to the goal for the offensive rebound.
Some unlikely candidates maybe going to step up because of foul trouble and injuries. Miles gets free. Tarver with a block.
Tarver wants some playing time.
Langford, nice look. Jan. Kansas gets it back again.
Where's Mr. Langford? They got to get him going. Mr. Langford.
Instead, the swing to Giddens. Giddens on the drive.
That's good, though. I like to see him go to the basket a little bit more.
A push on Georgia Tech. Underneath the basket, Jan was sent flying. And the foul will go on Ismail Mohammed, his second.
Take a look right now. 1 for 8 out of Langford. 2 for 7 out of Miles. 3 for 8 out of Giddens. The big three have to respond. You got to step up. When the star is on the sideline and you're a star player, you got to respond, especially at home.
Giddens looking inside for Christian Moody. Moody around Tarver. Got it.
He's actually done a really solid job, dude. Talk to Howie Schwab, our expert research guy. He was singing his praises.
Fine to the other end, exploding to the hoop is fouled. Moody now with 6 points today. Again, he's gone from being a walk-on who never played to a walk-on who came off the bench, now to a walk-on who's a starter on the number two ranked team in the country.
There's a little jump hook in the lane, gets that score. They honored at halftime Darnell Valentine, played back here years ago. Ted Owens' era, for some reason, has never been recognized like it's being recognized now by Lou Perkins and his staff, recognizing the former greats that played during that era.
Valentine still the all-time leader in steals in the school and fifth in both scoring and assists.
Number two is Danny Manning. I was shocked. I said, Danny, I didn't know you were number two in steals. He said, really? I said, yeah.
Either.
And number three, I said, look at Danny, one of the most versatile players to ever play in college, led that Larry Brown team to the national title in 1988. Number three is Miles in steals.
Unable to get to the basket today as he normally is. Normally, he can get to the basket against just about anybody.
Jared Jack's doing a great job defending.
Yep.
He really is.
So strong. Moody, the bounce pass inside for Jan, and there's Jack getting down to the baseline to steal it. The floater is good. Again, he is so strong on the drive, you just can't stop him.
I can see why the super guard, Howard Garfinkel, loves him. When he speaks about Jared Jack, he said, I tried to convince them that he should have been a McDonald's High School All-American. He said, a legitimate big-time player. And you are right, Mr. Garfinkel.
A 7-point lead in the half is up to 11, thanks to Jared Jack. Last year in the Elite Eight in St. Louis, Kansas rallied from a 7-point deficit late. A bank shot by Langford, a late three by J.R. Giddens forced overtime. Tech had a chance to win in the end of regulation, could not convert, so it was on to OT. And in OT, it was all Tech. The Yellow Jackets advancing to the Final Four with a 79-71 overtime victory over Kansas. Bill Self, of course, just here last year. Prior to that, under Roy Williams, a couple of Final Fours, but a tremendous amount of success for this program the last 3 years. And these seniors, Miles and Simeon and Langford, this is it for them, Dick. They're trying to take that one last step and win it all.
That's the reason Simeon came back to school.
A block by Schencher.
They got some shot blockers inside.
Nice look from the wing. Another three for Aaron.
I tell you, Miles has shot the ball well from the perimeter. He's made 3 threes here this afternoon.
Dick in 3 attempts and on the year, Miles is now 9 for 14 from three-point range.
Well, that tells me he better shoot a little more.
A guy who used to get criticized a lot for not being able to shoot.
Oh, hey, look at
that.
Look at the big guy stepping out. Said, anything you can do, I can do better.
His first three-point attempt of the season, and it goes down. Langford finally gets one to go.
They need Langford. Last 5 games, averaging 18 a game. First 3, average 9. Has been coming on strong. This afternoon, it's been tough. It's 2 for 9.
Just 4 points on the day for Langford. Bynum. Langford got flattened by Bynum after he delivered the pass. Jack gets back the loose ball for the Yellow Jackets. Tarver. And that shot was contested by Giles.
Good job by Giles.
Miles feeling it.
Why not? ball. Why not? Who said he can't shoot? Who said that's one of his weak areas? He's dancing with joy. He knows he has them back in the day. And all the faithful here, they love their Jayhawks. What a passion they have.
Maybe an unlikely source, Aaron Miles. You think of him distributing, but today he's filling it up. He's got 4 threes and 13 points in the game.
And that was my definition of leadership, that he had to step up offensively without the presence of Simeon. The club was struggling offensively. Couldn't get a good shot. Really, really fighting and scrapping. He steps up, makes the three, four consecutive up, and four consecutive shots from the three-point range.
And how much does this game mean to Aaron Miles? How much emotion is there for him today? Look at that.
Well, it was Heartbreak City when they lost on March 28 at the Edward Jones Dome in St. Louis, with Jaren Jack dominating the overtime, scoring 8 out of 13.
Certainly both of these teams legitimate contenders to get back to St. Louis. This time, that would mean getting to the Final Four. That's where it's going to be held this year.
Without a doubt, my friend, they are definitely legit contenders, along with about 15 other teams out there and a quality basketball team.
Got to get healthy. Elder straining a hamstring today. He won't return. Simeon out with a broken thumb. Bynum on the drive, and we've got a foul. Remember, against Kansas, it'll go on Miles.
We're witnessing both clubs here without a key part of their team. Elder offensively for Georgia Tech, and Simeon certainly for Kansas.
Correction on the foul. They've given it to Giles. That would be his fourth. Kansas within six. A great player from Kansas's recent past, Drew Gooden, out to a standing ovation. His number's been retired here at Allen Fieldhouse, and a guy now enjoying a lot of success in the NBA with the Cleveland Cavaliers.
I think he found a home and he played with LeBron James. Remember, I told you during the telecast that James was the best high school player I've ever seen in my one of the last 20 years. And right now, my friends, remember this. He's probably the MVP of the NBA. Just turned 20. Unreal. Terrific, LeBron James.
Let's go to Doris Burke with some thoughts on Aaron Miles. Doris?
Aaron Miles committed this season a 28% career three-point shooter. He's done better than that today. But I think when you look at a point guard, guys, what you think about are turnovers. Assist to turnover ratio. How good is he with the basketball? Well, consider this. His first 2 years, triple digits in turnovers. Last season as a junior, 89. Dick, much better.
Yeah, he really, I'll tell you one thing, he's a winner too, Doris. He has the special qualities that coaches love. Just plays hard defensively.
Gentry, the jump hook. Rolls out on him. Rebound Langford. Kansas has got a chance to cut it down even
there.
More.
It is. There it is. The three by Gooden. He ran right to that three-point line. He can do that if he squares his body. His dilemma is shot selection. Understanding a good shot. Obviously had a great look right there.
And give the assist to Aaron Miles.
Closing in on John Vaughn's record of 804 assists. They've been in this game at 800.
Kansas was down as many as 16 in the first half. And it's out of bounds to Georgia Tech. But Kansas right back in this game.
You have to salute this crowd. They've been a great sixth man as you watch Giddings with the three-point shot from the wing. Right from the get-go when they were down, as he's two away from the record, Mr. Miles. They did not allow this club to quit.
You're right.
If you remember, I talked about how they're really great fans because so many fans are front runners. Not here. This crowd stayed with this team when they were down 16.
And Aaron Miles did not allow his team to quit. Never mind that there's no Simeon. Never mind they were down 16. Now they're down only three. Rashawn Dickey getting good position inside on Moody. And he will draw the foul. Well, that's a good-looking move by that freshman inside.
They got two diaper dandies that I think are going to be special tomorrow in Dickey. Certainly, guys are going to get quality minutes. As you look at Bill Self, three times to the Elite Eight in his young coaching career.
Dick, that foul on Moody, his third. And now Sasha Khan is going to check back into the next opportunity. Bill Self trying to rotate his big guys and just keep somebody on the floor, keep him out of foul trouble. Giles has four fouls, remember.
He's got three bodies that can rotate in that position with Khan, Jackson, and Giles. They walk. Control by Michael Jitz. Excellent ball. Look in violation. Look at the pivot foot. Up the bow is certainly on his side. Not a Paul Hewitt side.
Dick, tomorrow night at 8:30 Eastern, ESPN's final NFL game of the season. The Cowboys at the Giants, showcasing a couple of great rookie talents, Julius Jones and Eli Manning. The game also available in high definition on ESPN HD. Kansas might be able to tie right now. Air ball. Galindo misses the easy one underneath, and back comes Tech.
He hurried that shot. Had a good opportunity.
Muhammad. Jack underneath with the reverse.
Nice reverse layup by Jack. Got out in transition. It's Mom Louise. What a fan she is. The dad, the brother, they're all here. They drive across this country to come to see this kid play.
Excited. I wouldn't want to miss this if my son were playing. A steal now by McHenry. Numbers again. Bynum. And Langford brings it down. And is fouled.
Bynum normally scores in transition from that wing. One of the all Marco Polo players, transfers, traveling man, left out in zone, great program. Take a look at the transition. There's the kick out. Not going to find Jack. Jack with the reverse layup. Very difficult to block. Used the actual rim as a defense right there.
That last foul on Georgia Tech on Muhammad, his third. And Muhammad has gone out right now. So it's Tarver and McHenry and Dickey up front. No Schencher, no Muhammad. A different looking lineup right now for the Yellow Jackets.
And the big question right now is, will Kansas fall out of the unbeaten list of eight? Will it be down to seven?
Galindo!
Galindo can score. That's now 14 points in 17 minutes the other night. Came out of that St. Benedict's program. That's his strength, shooting the basketball.
Came into the game today with 44 minutes this season and 35 points. Timeout, Georgia Tech.
And remember, without the post presence of Simeon inside, they have now gone exclusively to the perimeter.
Yep.
And the three-point shot has really been a plus for them.
Kansas is 8 for 16 from three-point range today. Miles has 4, Giddens has 3, and now Galindo with a huge shot to get him within 2.
And that's created by the penetration right there of Miles. Draws 3 people to him. Square your body, and that's what good shooters do, and that's what Galindo did right there.
It's an 11-2 run for Kansas, and this is why, Dick, assuming that Simeon comes back healthy, when he does, Bill Self feels they might be a better team because they're going to learn about Galindo and Kahn and Giles.
He's
and
right.
Jackson.
He's right. I agree with him. I think there's no question on a short term as you look at the unbeaten team. Illinois has got a date with Ohio State coming up on the 5th. Boston College undefeated's got a date at Massachusetts. Remember, Connecticut went there and lost. Pittsburgh has got Bucknell. That's a W, even though Bucknell beat St. Joe's. Texas A&M's undefeated. They go at Penn State and then at Kansas. Ouch. And then West Virginia has got a date at NC State, who's going to be an angry team after being embarrassed by Norm Roberts at St. John's.
63-45. Schencher, nice look underneath, and Jack will finish and draw the foul.
Is he a bright player? What a great IQ. Knows how to rotate to the inside, inverts really well, goes from the perimeter to the interior. There he is, wide open, lack of communication defensively. I love Jared Jack. I tell you, watching his development, only thing I'm angry with, I'm not in his cell phone. Jack Wilkerson wrote he has 400
people.
He has LeBron in there. He has in there every big name imaginable.
I bet you this. I bet you he's better at programming numbers into his cell phone than you are at yours.
Well, that's why I use you to program all.
one of the many off-air roles.
Oh, you got a lot of those, baby.
J.R. Giddens the foul, his first. Jack now with 17 points today. Giddens a little bit long, and a great job there by the freshman, Mario West, or a sophomore rather, out of Douglasville, Georgia, to hold off his man for the rebound.
Yeah, he blocked out exceptionally well in that possession. You don't see the blockouts that often.
6'4 guy who specializes in rebounding and defense.
He's got great legs, great balance.
Kansas has never led in this game.
You Schencher a little bit on the inside.
There
you
it
Schencher.
Is. There it is. Knocked away, though.
Go back to him.
They got to get a shot off here in a hurry. West. And the rebound to Kansas as they just beat the shot clock but missed the shot. Russell Robinson has returned now for Kansas.
Three freshmen on the floor with Robinson, Galindo, and Klon.
Miles not in the game right now. Langford. And it'll stay with Kansas. More than ever, they need Langford to do some things right now if the Jayhawks are going to win this game.
Well, yeah, Miles trying to get a little break right there. Danger time for Kansas without him on the floor.
Welcome back to Lawrence, where the Jayhawks making a big push, and I'm joined by the number four overall pick in the 2002 draft and one of the most accomplished Kansas Jayhawks. You played here, Drew. How difficult can this arena be on an opponent coming in here?
It's tough. I mean, you saw Coach Hewitt in the first half trying to call a timeout and couldn't get it. Didn't nobody hear him. Referees didn't hear him. I mean, it gets real loud, and it's a hard place to play at, but it's a great place to play at when you're on Kansas.
Young NBA career, but you've been a few places. Obviously, the question... LeBron James, what's it like to play alongside of him?
It's great. I mean, he makes it easier for a lot of us on the team with his passing ability and his athletic ability. And we have a great guys on the team with Ilgauskas and Jeff McGinnis. So, you know, sky's the limit for that team.
You were acquired after they traded away Carlos Boozer. What is your role for them?
My role is just go out there and just be scrappy and get rebounds and play defense, and the rest will come.
What's going to put this team over the top? Kansas made a great run.
I think, you know, they're setting for a lot of outside shots right now because of the low post presence without having Simeon. But we keep knocking down shots and getting stops on the defensive end like we have. We'll get the win.
Drew, great to see you back here, Mr. Lynn. Thank you very much. Guys.
All right, Doris, thank you. Wild shot there by Robinson. He's right. It's been all outside shooting for Kansas without Simeon. The Jayhawks, Dick, have only shot two free throws in the entire game.
Well, that's because they had not attacked the basket. Everything's a perimeter jump shot as you're looking good. And I think he definitely found a hole. Paul Silas, a perfect guy for him. And certainly LeBron James. He just makes everyone better. That cliche that we utilize. And that's what makes him so special. Right now, prior to this little recent injury, LeBron would probably be the MVP of the NBA.
The sharpshooting freshman, Anthony Morrow, has returned to the game now for Georgia Tech. Miles getting a little physical with Muhammad down to the block, so Miles will be called for the foul. That'll be his second.
Bill Self looks a little concerned right there, likes being at home. They haven't left here. They don't leave until they go out to play Kentucky on January 9th.
They've also got a road game at Villanova on ESPN January 22nd, plus, of course, the rugged Big 12. Schencher, that pass only gets caught if he's throwing it to himself down there.
Jay Wright's basketball team is a lot better than people believe. Beat Penn the other night by 10. They've only got one loss. Villanova got some good veteran players there with Ray Sumter and company.
We talk a lot about the top of the Big East, but the middle of the Big East, pretty good as well. There's what Kansas has done. A win over Wisconsin, Milwaukee, and Kemper Arena in Kansas City. Otherwise, all seven games here. Although, as Bill Self points out, the Villanova game was originally supposed to be early and got rescheduled for February. And the Kentucky game is on the road as well.
They were supposed to play the coaches versus Kansas.
Right.
And that was taken away because of the ruling by the courts.
Giddens can't get the shot off over Morrow. Robinson over Schencher. Galindo, or Khan rather, trying to keep it alive, and Anthony McHenry gets called for the foul, and that's a big one. It's his fourth.
He's such a valuable player. With Elder out of the game right now, McKenzie on the sideline is a real minus for Georgia Tech.
Here comes Otis Tarver to take his place.
And a plus for Bill Self. And what about Bill Self playing the role of professor? He graded his team. See the grade?
He gave him a solid B, right?
He gave him a solid B. He said, I cannot give him an A. He said, I give him a solid B because we're not rebounding. We're not shooting the ball like I expect.
Tarver now called for the foul. He admits he grades kind of tough. But this is the first ranked team that Kansas has played. We saw them beat St. Joe's. They've also beaten South Carolina, TCU, Nevada. But this is by far the toughest test that they've had so far this season.
Well, two of their wins over Vermont and South Carolina, they had to really attribute the free throw line where they won the basketball game. Many more attempts, and they were able to get to the winner's circle if you look at the margin of difference in the free throw line in those two games.
The window calling for it. Khan working hard for position down to the post. Robinson overhandling a little bit, gets it back, and finds Giddens.
He thought about it. And
he
said, uh-oh.
He said, I'm a little too close to my coach over on the bench to shoot this three.
He's going to shoot that from Kansas City.
Shot clock at 7. Miles, did he travel? Yes, he did. Tony Green got him with a good call.
Tony Green doing a great job here tonight along with Mr. Kitts and certainly Donnie Gray. Yeah. Really a solid job out of three officials this afternoon.
Especially the way the game has been played.
Yes.
Frantic and physical the whole day.
And he has been frantic, no doubt. Very physical, very aggressive. Both clubs get a lot of pride on the defensive side.
That's Muhammad being defended by Giddens. Two spectacular athletes.
That's why poor Ewell was very upset when they lost against Gonzaga. Thought they broke down from their strength, their defensive side.
Here's Robinson on the feed from Miles.
He's going to be a star. Robinson will be a star in a Jayhawk uniform. He's got the great strength of body. Comes out of a great program at Rice High School in New York City.
And that should be the assist that gives Aaron Miles a share of the Kansas record along with Jock Vaughn. That assist there for Miles, his fourth. Give him 804 in his career, tying Jock Vaughn for the KU record.
And you're going to watch him right now. There's the kick out. Easy layup. Robinson takes it for the goal, and Miles gets another milestone. He'd rather have right now the plus on the scoreboard.
Yep.
That's the kind of kid he is. He also broke the Big 12 record.
Held by one of our co-workers now, Doug Gottlieb.
He did a great job when he played at Oklahoma State at 793. Trying to double up inside.
Gentry from 15.
He said, I did it once, right out again.
Galindo, he is working hard out there. Galindo has really given him a spark. Langford has returned now for the Jayhawks. Kansas has never led in this game. Langford on the drive, blocked from behind by Morrow. Bynum, Muhammad lost the handle on the way up.
Yeah, he lost the basketball.
Got a foul call, though.
You couldn't believe it. There was a foul finally called, no question.
Well, Hewitt wanted to travel at the other end. The foul on Morrow is third. Here comes Kansas, trailed by as many as 16. They've never led.
Never led? Bottom line, it's been a long time since they tied.
Langford with the glass, and now Langford comes up injured. May have gotten poked in the eye.
Strong drive by Langford. That's his game. He's a slasher, a scorer. Forms one of the best trios in college basketball. Miles, Simeon, and himself. This is his strength, Dan, taking the ball to the basket. Goes up strong. He's a left-handed player coming to the strong side.
Morrow clipped him. Watch Morrow's right arm. Right there. Clipped him in the right eye or near the right eye. Langford goes out. Simeon out with a bad thumb after the surgery on the torn ligament. Elder out for Georgia Tech for the rest of the day with a strained hamstring.
Simeon looked good working out, though, this morning. Yeah, watching him shoot, catch and shoot.
Shenson. And we've got a push. Is that Giles? Giles of Kansas has just fouled out of the game. Seems every time he came in, he picked up a quick foul and had to go right back out, and they've lost Giles for the rest of the day.
They have fouls to give in that position, though, with the players they can rotate into that area of the floor.
Three freshmen, Giles, Jackson, and Kahn, all splitting the minutes. One name we haven't mentioned, and we should mention, and this is water under the bridge.
Paget?
David Paget, right, who decided to transfer out after last season and will be a Louisville Cardinal next year.
See how I read your mind, work together so often?
You know what, that frightens
me. I tell you, that Rick Pitino's really happy, by the way, with the performance of Paget in practice. And we want to send our sympathy to Rick Pitino, pass it to his mom,
yes,
Charlotte.
Definitely. Don't forget, Wednesday night, it's Princeton against Duke at Cameron Indoor Stadium. J.J. Redick and the Blue Devils, ranked sixth, unbeaten, take on the Princeton Tigers Wednesday night, 7 Eastern on ESPN. You talk about Redick and Ewing and Sheldon Williams, certainly one of the terrific trios in college basketball, but I know you like the trios these two teams have as well.
Well, I think when you've got three outstanding players at three parts of the floor covered, you have a chance to get to the winner's circle. And there's certain teams out there that have terrific trios. I don't think there's any better than the one that's Chapel Hill when you talk certainly Felton, McCants, and Manny.
One of the bonus for Shenshur, and he knocks down the first. And let's take a look at Dickie V's terrific trios.
Yeah, those trios that I really, really like. Take a look right there. Certainly going to like the trio down in Illinois. I mean, they used to have, I remember labeling them the Flying Illini when they had Kendall Gill and company. Now it's Flying Illini Part 2. I mean, they're so explosive, Brown and Williams and Head. I'll tell you, a danger game for them. is when they make that journey to Madison, Wisconsin.
January 25th on ESPN. Wisconsin with a nice win over Alabama a couple of days ago. Nice tic-tac-toe passing. And it's going to wind up with Christian Moody going to the line for the Jayhawks.
I think Moody has been really aggressive on the inside. Here's a kid that's earned his PT, his playing time in practice. Busted his gut to get where he's at. The young kids out there can take a little theory in life. If you have great work ethic, a sense of pride, a passion of what you're doing, you can be shocked at some of the good things that can happen in your life. And remember, don't make bad judgments in your personal life about the drug, the alcohol scene. You can't win playing that game.
Number four on Muhammad. Moody is a junior out of Asheville, North Carolina, Roy Williams country. And today, Dick, will surpass the total number of minutes he played all of last season. Wayne Simeon, out of the injury for several more weeks, easily the best free throw shooter on the team. The rest of the group under 60%. That's the kind of thing that catches up to you.
Yeah, I read an article by Mr. Woodling, who writes here in the local Lawrence paper about that, how the free throw shooting could really hurt him, and certainly documented the fact that, as we saw statistically right there, 88% with the big fella right here, and then it's really a struggle with everyone else. Oh, they're back, man. We got ourselves a Mailock Smasher on New Year's Day. Have a party, a hoops party here in Lawrence, Kansas, at one of the great venues in a college game.
Chancer doesn't like it.
Defense has made this happen for Kansas. Defense plus three-point shooting didn't allow Georgia Tech to put the knockout punch.
ESPN's exclusive presentation of college basketball is brought to you by Alka-Seltzer. Break up the full feeling of indigestion and pain with Alka-Seltzer.
Back here at Allen Fieldhouse in Lawrence, Kansas, along with Dick Vitale and Doris Burke, I'm Dan Schulman. What a New Year's Day game it's been. It looked like Kansas might get blown out here early today, but they've got a 16-point deficit from the first half down to one right now, and Aaron Miles, 4 for 11, you say, hey, that's not so impressive, but all four have been threes, and Jarrett Jack, again, has been a star for Georgia Tech.
Well, two of the real strong mindsets in college basketball at the point guard slot. Both have a winner's mentality. Everything they do reflects their coaches. They had a chance for a knockout punch, did not apply in Georgia Tech.
Yep.
When Elder went out, they seemed to change their aggressive style in terms of attacking the basket. Back before you had documented that at halftime, talking to our Doris Burke.
Remember, Kansas has not led in this game. They got a shot right here.
This is the guy that can get him there. If he can get a driving lane, he loves to drive. Langford.
Galindo looking very confident. Giddens for three. Loose ball out of bounds. It'll stay with the Jayhawks.
Dale Sayers in the house today, former Kansas Jayhawks superstar. Look at B.J. Elder on the sideline. 19-6 when he went out of the game.
Elder with a strained hamstring will not return today. Georgia Tech, of course, used to playing without him or with a hobbled Elder as they did in the NCAA tournament last year. Dickey got a piece of that driving layup by Keith Langford.
Right guy to shoot the ball, though, and that's what you want Langford to do, but you got to credit the defense of Georgia Tech, giving help to one another. That's a part of the game that Bynum said he had to really buy into it, learn it, doubling up on the basketball.
Great show, great trap there by Moody and Langford, but they find Bynum.
And a heady play by Bynum is step one step behind the line of the trap. So many guys run away from the ball.
There's Dickey inside. Nice aggressive move. Missed the shot. Jayhawk ball.
Gotta have patience with the right shot.
Langford for the lead. And the rebound of Rashawn Dickey.
They gotta make a few more extra passes looking for the right shot with that possession.
Paul Hewitt wants another timeout. Georgia Tech, Dick, has scored only 16 points so far in the second half.
Well, the one thing that has to be credited is that Kansas has done a phenomenal job in the second half of negating the transition game of Georgia Tech. Georgia Tech was dominating with the transition game early in this game.
Let's go back to Doris Burke. Doris?
Well, Dan, you and Dick have talked all day about the atmosphere inside of Kansas Arena. I'll tell you this, it's been so loud in here that the players can't hear the officials call. You see the change. Well, the end zones, respectively, taken up by what is known as the Kansas Campers. And this is what they do each 7 to 10 days prior to every home game. It's about location. These students already have their tickets. What they're trying to do is be the first person in line. Essentially 66 different groups represented by one person. 30 people in groups, so approximately 2,000 people camping out 7 days prior, not for tickets, simply to get the best seats in the house. They love their Jayhawks.
They get some great seats, but they don't get any better than ours, Doris. And we get paid. Don't tell them that, Doris.
And you don't have to line up. You just breeze in.
Doris does a phenomenal job on outside on for us.
Yes, she does. Schencher misses the 17-footer. McHenry playing with four fouls, runs down the rebound. Jack the floater and the soft touch.
Why not?
He shushes the crowd on his way back down the floor.
Right, he has to play basketball. I don't worry about all those antics, shushing the crowd. He's too good a player. You think about point guards, Bobby Clemens certainly started the run. You talk about great point guards, Mark Price and company.
Galindo with a wide open look, tipped back by Moody, but out of bounds to Georgia Tech.
I think of Kenny Anderson and Stephon Marbury as you look at Jack right now, going to float, split the defense, a little floater in the lane, gets the conversion. You think of Travis Best, Drew Barry.
They had some great ones here in the last 20 years.
I want to send my best out to Drew Barry and his family. His little girl, Kylie, is battling cancer. Drew, our hearts and prayers are with you for a miracle for little Kylie.
I read it.
It was a touching story.
Another floater by Jack, and all of a sudden, Tech is back up by five. Jarrett Jack, a game high 21.
That's again, you know, symptomatic of last year, how he would not allow them to lose. He did every big play. The Langford finally comes back. One of the stars steps up and makes a big play.
Langford with a jumper, but Mike Pitts has called time. They want to see if that
was
a two or a three.
Or two.
Yeah. No official made any kind of a signal as to whether it was a two or three, so they're going to go to the monitor and check.
Well, you're allowed to use the monitor in that situation. I personally think the monitor is used too often now in college basketball, breaking the flow of the game.
Well,
we're
going to
watch right here. Did he step on the line? Is he behind the line? He's blocking our view right here. Ooh.
Tough to tell from that angle. Good screen by Moody to free him up.
Well, I got one eye, so it's tough for me to tell at any angle, but I would say looking there, I thought it looked pretty good right there. Now, you know, speaking about, since we got a little break in the action, I'm going to take another look right here. This should be a better angle here.
Looks pretty good, I think.
Looks like he took off from behind the line. It looks like he took off from behind the line.
Oh, no, they decided it's a two.
Two, he said he touched
it.
They have better eyes than we do.
So it's a three-point deficit for the Jayhawks, 5.5 to go.
You know, one thing I don't like happening in the ACC is the schedule. I don't like the fact that a North Carolina plays Wake only one time. For example, Georgia Tech now plays against North Carolina, Maryland, and Virginia only one time. That's the addition of Virginia Tech and Miami.
Yeah, Boston College next year.
I really don't like that. I used to love those matchups.
Three-point game here at Allen Fieldhouse in Lawrence, Kansas. With Dick Vitale and Doris Burke, I'm Dan Schulman. A New Year's Day special, and it has been special here this afternoon. Kansas without Wayne Simien, trailed by as many as 16. They're down three now. Georgia Tech is playing without B.J. Elder, who strained a hamstring in the first half.
Half-court game right now. Tough defense. Made him take a deep shot, and he nails it.
How clutch is he?
How big is he? How much of a star has he become? Responding at quality time. Three plays in a row he has made here late.
Miles, good look. Giddens wide open with the answer.
And they come right back to hang right in the ball game. Down only three. But what a performance in the last 2 minutes by Jarrett Jack.
And Dick, that assist by Aaron Miles gives him the Kansas record.
As the Big 12 record as well, has been a winner, two journeys to the Final Four. Last year would have been three in a row, except Jarrett Jack says, you're not going three in a row, baby. We're going from Atlanta, where they've become now the hot ticket in basketball.
No question. Meanwhile, Anthony McHenry has fouled out for Georgia Tech, and he's been a very, very valuable performer for Georgia Tech here today. the Ramblin' Wreck or the Yellow Jackets, however you want to call them, and the Jayhawks, you and I had high hopes. When we got our schedules in October and saw this baby for New Year's Day, we had high hopes, and it's delivered.
Well, let me tell you this. I'm not giving up being with my family on New Year's Day for some unbelievable cupcake. This better have been good, and it has been quality. No doubt, I'm excited that I got a chance to sit here with you, partner.
This is fun. Happy New Year. It's
Happy
fun
New
to be
Year,
with you.
Dad. Happy New Year.
You've now seen Georgia Tech live, Maryland live, Duke live, North Carolina live. You haven't seen Wake yet live, I don't believe. But how does the top of the ACC stack up in your
Well, you know, it's really going to be an outstanding year. I give the edge to the kids down in Chapel Hill. I just love everything about that team. They have bench strength now. Jawan Williams has been more than just a support player. We talk about him and we talk about head at Illinois support players. They're more than that. I mean, take a look right there in the ACC. NC State, though, got humiliated by St. John's. I'm telling you, 10 points at halftime.
St. John's team that really is struggling just put a program back together, but Norm Roberts came up with a huge win. Now, we mentioned the free throw problems for both of these teams, more so for Kansas now because their best free throw shooter, Simeon, is out. Miles.
Prime time and responds at the prime time.
How about Will Bynum in the elevation after the feed from Jared Jack?
Jared Jack made the steal, kicks it out. Look at the little guy. Up, up, and away.
That's ridiculous for a 5'11
oh,
guy.
Oh, look back. At him jam. Slam, jam, bam. The little guy from Chicago. And then Mr. Langford says, I'm just stepping back, knocking down a trifecta.
Reaction to the Langford three that brought him back within one, but then Jared Jack, how many times have we said today he answered the challenge yet again? A guy who makes big shot and big play after big play when his team needs it the most.
He is a big-time performer. He had that 29 last year in a game in the Elite Eight. Also credit the fact that Kansas didn't roll over. Bill Self has to be happy with one thing here thus far. When they were down 16, playing without Simeon, not playing well, they could have rolled over. But they never, absolutely never, ever quit. As he stepped up into something out, that's what stars do. That's what life is done. That's what Jack has done. And now he's going to chuck Jared Jack.
Bynum on the drive, and he is fouled before the shot. Kansas has come all the way back to tie it. The foul is on Miles, his third. Keith Langford stepping up, Dick, as you said he must for Kansas to have a chance.
He has really responded. There he is with his second trifecta in a row as he knocks it down. And look at the jubilation.